Welcome to the finale of Serial Experiments Lane. Before I start the reaction, thank you so much to Aeonix for sponsoring these reactions. Massive thank you as well to all of our patrons for helping keep our channel alive. After the episode, I will do an initial discussion, and then afterwards I'll have some sort of midway point cutoff where I go and do a little bit of outside research before I come back and continue the discussion, so that hopefully I don't have some sort of really off-topic random theory about the show. Especially with a show like this, I feel like it benefits you as a viewer to do your own research outside, because like obviously we're not all well informed of the subjects that we're talking about within the show. I think that'll help expand our discussion a little better. But yeah, without further ado, you guys know what to do. I'm going to start the episode in 3, 2, 1, play. Oh, well, this is different. That is a hard question to answer. Whoa. Okay. Well, I guess all of us kind of only exist when we're being observed by others, right? Isn't that how it works, Schrodinger's cat? So Lane does exist within the world, or I guess the reality of people who experience her. But for those who don't, obviously she wouldn't exist. And, oh, this actually kind of reminds me of Persona 4. All the different versions of Lane are simply just given life from how people observe her, or how they believe that she is, right? Maybe. The anime doesn't really give any clear answers, and I could be very off base with a lot of the things that I say, so I'll do a little reading after the initial discussion, and we'll see where it goes. I will miss this OP, though. It's a very nice OP. The ED, not really a big fan of it, to be honest, but yeah. Ego? Like, the sense of self? It's being controlled by the id and the superego? Will Lane discover her own ego? Is that what this episode might be about? For him, he doesn't require one in order to achieve his goals. Rather, it's a hindrance. Well, yeah, she's freaking out, understandably. Finally. All reset, return. Are we gonna wind back everything? To the very first episode, maybe? But yeah, like, she really needed that. For both Arisu and for Lane. I can only consider, like, the little red spots at the shadows to just be a representation of, like, danger. The wired is always lurking. Everywhere underneath the surface. Is nobody gonna walk out? Does Lane even exist anymore? Here's the Iwakura family. But I bet you Lane's not gonna be here. Yeah. Voice crack. Somebody was supposed to be there. This is an odd feeling. Same hum, but nobody walking down the street this time. Does the wired still exist? Within this world? I would guess so. But Lane just doesn't exist within this world. No program that would merge the wire to reality. You're gonna try to mail Lane? But Lane doesn't exist, Arisu. Wait, who are you guys talking about? Oh! Yeah, the girl who died in the first episode. Oh, that's good. Did she realize? If you don't remember something, it never happened. Okay, yeah, she totally knows. You aren't remembered, you never existed. Okay. Lane. I feel very sad for Lane. But with how things turned out, this does seem to be the best ending. Oh, Lane? Oh, wait, isn't that the... Yeah, it is! The dude to deliver the computer parts, right? Is it? Or, oh wait, no, maybe this is the guy who was at Siberia, I think. Yeah, I think it was the guy who was at Siberia. That's good. Was that one of the knights? I think he was the guy who was the company owner? Or one of the... Wait. I don't know. Not sure. Oh, it's these guys. Or wait, or maybe this is the guy who works at Tachibana. It's hard to tell. I'm sorry. Good luck, dude. He's not having the best day of his life. But even with Lane gone, I guess they want to show us that the Wired still exists. What isn't remembered never happened. Memory is merely a record. You just need to rewrite that record. Oh, present time. Ha 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 ha. Back to the normal Sean again. Start every episode with this. Oh. Lane? Yeah. She's no longer connected to anybody. Her other self. But it is still very sad. So those were the ghosts that we were seeing. Just dead people's information. Damn, dude got erased. Oh, wait, maybe... The guy that we saw walking down the street was Masami himself. Yeah.
Highly unlikely. I don't think that's the answer that she'll come to. If you walk down that path again, it will just end up in the same place. Whose voice is this? It's not Masami again, right? Oh! It's Dad, yeah. Oh. Her protective suit. Wow. It's green now. That was a good moment. Do you know each other? Because you obviously recognize her, but the memories were already erased. I mean, Lane is always there, and everywhere, at all times. This is so sad, though. But also very happy.
Oh God.
But no to be continued. I mean, it is the final episode, but is there maybe an after credits? No, there is no after credits. That's it. Lane resets the world, erases everybody's memories of her, struggles a little bit with her inner self, but then finds peace. So I guess that she'll always be there, but she'll never attempt to merge the wired and reality again. Kind of has that like silent observer kind of feel to it. And to be honest with you, I don't think I fully understood why I was even crying, but internally I suppose I knew that I should be crying. Just sad. It's unfair. And I didn't know I was this attached to Lane. Oh God. Funny how that works out, you know? I guess I fell in love with Lane and I don't even know why. Yeah, apologies, I'm getting a little too emotional. I can't even think straight. My tears won't stop coming down for some reason. I'm gonna take a small break and do some research, and then we'll come back and have an actual discussion. Right, so after some reading and a few minutes of just sitting here and thinking about the entire show, I feel like the show is about love and human connection. Because as we see here, the thing that Lane has learned, the reason why Lane has made the choices that she has, is because she understands love and she feels love towards humanity and towards Arisu, to be more specific. Which is why here in the end, she also comes to visit her, I guess in a way as like to renew that love for them. Because Lane has essentially made the ultimate sacrifice. She will forever be everywhere, and yet no one will ever know that she's there. She connects everyone, but she isn't connected to them. That fate is so lonely and so sad and so tragic, and yet she will do it because she understands love and she feels love. I believe that's what the author or the show writer, whatever, the person who created Serial Experiments Lane was attempting to convey. Information is easily manipulated and certainly the wired is very convenient. However, it can never truly be a replacement for love and actual human connection. The other version of Lane that Lane was talking to in this episode is also her ego. I guess I should have realized this. It kind of is very similar to what happens in Persona 4. I don't want to spoil the game, so I'll just throw that out there. But like, the reason why Lane has so many different personalities is because it's literally just her. It's just her ego being manipulated, I guess you could say, or being controlled, being molded by complexes, or rather the way that others had viewed her and decided that she was this way. So ultimately, all of it was her, and it wasn't some sort of like multiple personality disorder or anything like that. It was her. It was just her ego being molded by the world around her, by the people around her, I should say. And through that struggle, she was able to come to this conclusion, one that was given to her by her father, in quotation marks, because obviously that wasn't her actual father. Like, even she knows that he's not her father, but the thing that he was supposed to represent was the father figure, right? The person to come in and tell her that it's okay, that she doesn't need to wear this protective outer shell, which is the bear pajamas. And I suppose to give her peace of mind with this decision that she's come to. With how weird and bleak the show has been, the show makes me feel glad to be alive, to have a physical body, to be capable of creating connections with other people and being able to love others, you know? It was certainly told in a very abstract way, one that honestly I wouldn't expect anybody to really get on their first watch. If you did get it on your first watch, then congrats to you, sir. But despite how hard it is to understand the message sometimes, I feel like no matter what, no matter who watches this, deep down, they will understand it subconsciously. Similar to how I was just sitting here crying the entire episode without really understanding why I was crying. It was certainly a unique experience. All right, well, I've just been kind of like sitting here for a few minutes just thinking and reminiscing and feeling things. It's getting kind of weird. So I think I'm just gonna summarize how this anime is and what I think of it. It's hard for me to give a rating for the show because, like, if you look at it objectively, there's a lot of ways that you can deduct points from it. However, the emotions that it has made me feel and the message that it tells and the scary accuracy of it, even though this anime came out quite a while ago, and yet it still rings true today, I would honestly have to give this show a 9 out of 10. It's not like perfect in my opinion, but I can't really give it anything lower than a 9 out of 10 simply based off of how masterfully the show manipulates you, the knowledge that shows you your feelings, and ultimately delivers you with an amazing message, one that I'm sure anybody can feel to their core. Even more so, people who live within this day and age in the world of information and technology. I'm baffled by how the creators of the show, or I believe it was a game at first, were able to foresee all of this. And I'm sure, while it might not be extremely clear, I'm sure that this inspired a lot of creators after it. To expand on more of like why I would give the show a 9 out of 10, I guess I'll talk about the different facets of the show. Firstly, one of the most obvious things of the show is cinematography and how the majority of it is told through imagery. There are very few lines of dialogue in certain episodes, and being able to sit here and try to pick apart what exactly the show wants me to know, what kind of information are they trying to tell me, or in certain episodes, what kind of false information are they trying to tell me in order to showcase a point, right? That information can be easily manipulated. I found it fascinating how the show played with that concept, and honestly, I can't really think of any other thing that is comparable to it. Maybe I just haven't watched enough. In terms of animation itself, it's nothing to write home about. It's very basic animation, but it gets the point across, and there were certainly some scenes where it popped off, just like in last episode's physical transformation of Masami. That was pretty good. But it didn't need to be amazing. The show was here to tell a message, and it got that point across. The music was also another tool that was used to create atmosphere and to convey something to the viewer, whether that be fear or honestly just general confusion. There weren't really any banger tracks apart from the OP, I would say. That's not the point of the music. It was simply there as a tool to facilitate the message. Something that I probably didn't mention enough is the main character's voice acting. Lane's VA is very good at differentiating between each personality. You can clearly tell which Lane it is, even though the camera doesn't do some sort of like cutaway, or even if the characters don't react to it, you just know that that's Lane of the Wired, or that's the other more timid Lane, or that's the, you know, evil side of Lane. They're all still Lane, but you can tell just from the voice. Now, would I recommend this to anybody? That's hard to say. With the first episode literally being called weird, and I also feel like the first episode was just there to make you feel uncomfortable and weird, it would probably be a very hard sell to anybody who wasn't willing to watch the entire season, because most definitely you need to watch it all the way to, well, episode 12, episode 13. Yeah, just finish it in order to understand the intent of the creator. If you're not able to get through all of that, then you're probably just left weirded out and confused and wondering why your friend recommended this show to you. So yeah, I would say it's another more difficult one to recommend. One that people would definitely consider to just be a cult classic. Regardless, thank you so much, Aeonix, for recommending this show to me. I really enjoyed my time with it, and I'm glad that there are shows out there that can help expand my way of thinking and how I see the world, you know? It's always great when you find a piece of media that can do that for you. But yeah, that's gonna do it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching these reactions. I hope you guys enjoyed Serial Experiments Lane as much as I did, and I'll catch you in the next one.